What's going on, guys? Capcus here, and I'm back with another video. And today, I'm going to continue my top 100 series. And last video, I was, quiet because everyone was sleeping on. I'm going to be not really loud, but like a good amount of volume today. So, I don't know why I did that right. Okay. So, guys, for today's video, I'm going to be giving you guys number 50 through 11 today. And my top 25 is going to include pictures this time, the pictures of other movies. So, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. But before I start, I want you guys to drop a like, subscribe, comment down below. Tell me guys what you guys' favorite movies. And yeah, let's start this list. Outside, the winter sky turning gray. City up in smoke, it's only ash when it rains. How I let the morning go to sleep in the day. Love for everybody to the drugs. Okay, guys, coming in the 50s, from number 50 to number 40, we have Wolf of Wall Street at 50, 49 to Spectral Me. 48, Hobbs and Shaw. 47, Jumanji. 46, Alvin and the Chipmunks. 45, Django Unchained. 44, Shrek 2. 43, Fast 5. 42, Batman Begins. 41, 8 Mile. And 40, Up. Okay, let's start with Wolf of Wall Street. I recently, Django Unchained and Wolf of Wall Street, I recently watched, last month. And I love them both. They're really good movies. People want to put them a lot high. I wouldn't put them a lot high. I was going to put Wolf of Wall Street really high. But because of the amount of profanity it has and everything. And everything. I really don't feel like putting it that high. Because of, well, I have a dumb reason for that. But I really don't think I really want to put it that high. But it is a good movie though. Leonardo DiCaprio is amazing as always. Playing the role of Jordan Belfort. Jonah Hill is amazing as well. Yeah, good movie. It's Spectral Me. But one of my favorite trilogies, animation trilogies. And the first movie just kicks it all off. It does it really well. You have a villain of Gru, who just wants to be the best villain he can possibly be, but ends up wanting to be a good guy at the end of the movie with three kids. So, not that he had, obviously, but, yeah. And then Hobbs and Shaw. People want to say Hobbs and Shaw is the best Fast and Furious movie. I don't think it's the best Fast and Furious movie, personally, but I do think it's a really good one, though. The Rock and Jason Statham say them doing good as always. And I don't know how to say his name, but Idris Elba, amazing villain. And
on, guys, editing Chris here. I just want to let you guys know that I cut this part out because I put something I cut in the middle of this because my family was being loud, so I didn't really want to record during that time. So I didn't really record until finish recording until nighttime. So that's where this video is going to leave off. Sorry about all this stuff. I really want to make this video exciting because I have some further announcements at the end of this video. Actually, no. I'm going to say the announcements at the end of my top 10 video. So I'll let you guys know about that.
Hey guys, sorry guys. I picked up this video at night today. So it's 7:30. It's 7:45 now. So sorry for this video is getting really weird now. So I apologize about that. But yeah, like I was saying, the villain in Hobbs and Shaw is really good. He played Heimdall in Thor, so he's a really good actor. He's probably one of the best villains in the Fast and Furious franchise, except the Shaw brothers. So that's what I like about him. And then what else? Jumanji's one of the funniest movies on this list. Jumanji's funny. The comedy in this movie is unbelievable. You just love to see Kevin Hart and The Rock together on screen. It's just so amazing. It really is. And then the plot is just good, too. There are some plot holes in the movie. And, and how that guy, I forgot his name, but, how he ends up staying in the Jumanji game for 18 years. I get they explained it, but I didn't, get it. So, yeah, that's what I want to say about that. And then what else? Alvin the Chipmunks is a clap. People are going to get mad at me for putting Alvin the Chipmunks over Wolf of Wall Street or Spectral Me, but I grew up with Alvin the Chipmunks. I have a brother that's named Alvin. My deceased brother was named Alvin. I grew up with Alvin the Chipmunks. I love this movie. I really do. The sequel is poop, but the rest of the movie franchise is good. I like it a lot. I really do. You guys can see why that. Before I continue, you guys can see that that's my Spider-Man 5 film poster. Even though it's not my favorite movie, because I don't have a post on my favorite movie, so I just put that through. But anyways, continue. So then, Django Unchained. Django Unchained is probably one of the best history-related movies. One of the best, other than, like, maybe Lincoln, but that's not even in my top. Like, Wolf, Wall Street, and Django, I recently watched, like, last month. It wasn't a movie I've seen. Oh, I saw this in theaters 2013, you know, or 2012, you know, when these movies came out. Like, I didn't see these movies in theaters. I recently just watched them. So I didn't grow up with this type of stuff, because, for one, they both have profanity. No, Wolf of Wall Street has, like, a lot of profanity, guys. If you guys look it up, Wolf of Wall Street has, like, 700 cuss words. I'm not even lying. You guys literally has the Guinness World Record of the most profanity in any movie. Except for maybe, like, two movies, but, like, those are, like, documentaries and stuff about cussing. But, like, yeah, Wolf of Wall Street has a lot of profanity, but, like, that's why the main reason why I didn't watch it, because of that. But overall, that's a good movie as well. And same thing with Django Unchained. Django Unchained doesn't really have that much cussing, really. It just, the use of the N-word is just, like, ugh. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. But, like, yeah, but Django Unchained is a really good history movie. Easily the best Civil War movie, for sure. Or Saving movie, and yeah. People can get mad for me for playing Shrek 2 over Django Unchained, but I grew up with Shrek 2. I could even like Shrek 2 more than the first Shrek, but I don't. But they're both equally the same. Other than the movies that are in between Shrek 1 and Shrek 2. Shrek 2, Fairy Godmother's she is an overrated villain, but she's also not a bad villain either. You know what I mean? Like, she's a good villain, but she's also not the best one, like what people say she is. Prince Charming literally was probably one of the best characters in this movie, other than Shrek and Donkey, of course. The plot of the movie is cool. The fact that, you know, this movie was just amazing, really. Not amazing, but like, it was amazing. It was like one of my favorite animation movies for sure, other than the ones I put above it. Now, 43, we have Fast Five. Fast Five, people, this movie is overrated, but Fast Five is still a good movie. Like, people want to say Fast Five is the best Fast and Furious movie ever. I don't think it's the best Fast and Furious movie. It's up there, but it's not the best Fast and Furious movie. It's a good movie. It's a good Fast and Furious. It's a good standalone Fast and Furious movie for sure. But is it the best Fast and Furious movie of the franchise? No, it's not. Except the one I literally put up high. But I'm not going to spoil where that's going to be. That's going to be at the end of this video. We'll have to find out at the end of this video. And Batman Begins. Batman Begins, I would say this is the worst, not the worst, but like, least interesting of the Dark Knight trilogy. If you want to say Dark Knight, why is this less interesting? Have you seen Batman Begins? It's a good origin story for a superhero, don't get me wrong, it is. But I personally prefer Iron Man's original story better, or origin story better. But like, yeah, man, Batman Begins is a good movie, but like, what's his name? Ra's al Ghul is a good villain, he is. But he's also overrated as well. There's a lot of overrated villains on this top 100 in these movies. You know what I mean? Like, they really are. But to be fair, Ra's al Ghul didn't make the movie a lot better. If it wasn't for Christian Bale and Ra's al Ghul, this movie would probably be trash. But because of those two, this movie is where it's at now. Oh, and also Gary Oldman, of course. I can't forget about him. Those three people probably made the movie where it is now. If it wasn't for those three, then the movie would be garbage. But yeah, I like that movie. And then 8 Mile. 8 Mile I recently watched as well, but I was like last year though. 8 Mile, Eminem being my favorite rapper, for him to be an actor in his first ever movie, he pulled it off really well. For someone who's never been acted before, that was a really good ass performance. It really was. And 8 Mile is something, because I'm from Detroit. Like, I was born and raised in Detroit, so I have a special connection to 8 Mile. Some sort, because I'm from the city. Like, not like the actual city itself, but like the metro part of the city. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I live half an hour from it. So, but yeah. 8 Mile is something that, yeah, people don't really look to as a good movie, but it's easily one of the best movies. If you're talking about like, movies about like, music and rap and all that, this is definitely the one. And yeah. You guys can see 40 is up. Like, I put up at 40. You guys can get mad at me for putting up that low. Up is a good movie. It really is. Like, people want to say, oh, it's only good because it's a montage of him and his wife and all that. I'm forgetting so many names in this whole series. You have no idea. That's not even a good thing. I don't know why. But, like, the main character, the old guy, he was probably the best part of this movie, and also the scout. And the villains are, like, they're okay. I like them. And, like, the plot, I think the plot is probably the best part of the movie. Like, the climax of this movie is probably the best part of this movie. Hey, guys, let's get to 39 to 30. At 39, we have Purge Election Year. At 38, we have Passion of Christ. 37, we have Star Wars Revenge of the Sith. 36, Toy Story 2. 35, Madagascar 2, Return to Africa. 34, Guardians of the Galaxy. 33, It Chapter 2. 32, Monsters, Inc. 31, Spider-Man 2. And 30, Spider-Man Homecoming. Now, that's a lot taken. Listen. A lot of people disagree with the fact that It Chapter 2 is above Guardians of the Galaxy. I personally think It Chapter 2 is better than Guardians of the Galaxy. Okay? People like say, oh, it's not a good horror movie. It's a good horror movie. It's not as good as people say. Like, to me, Purge Election Year is a lot more scary than It Chapter 2. But as a standalone movie, rather than the horror stuff, it's a good movie. Like, they're both really good movies. But I think Purge Election Year is a lot scarier than It Chapter 2. I would agree. But if we're talking about, horror movie standards, then yeah, I would put Purge Election Year above It Chapter 2. But a standalone movie, that's in general, the comedy in Chapter 2 was probably the best part, for sure. And obviously Pennywise, you know, for sure. Yeah, so Purge Election Year, I like this a lot. Frank Gilio is literally an amazing actor. And the actress for the senator. And this has to be the best Purge movie. If you guys don't think this is the best Purge movie, I don't know what taste you have in horror movies. I really don't. So I saw this movie in theaters when it came out. July 2016, I saw this movie when it came out. And it was amazing. I had an amazing experience studying this movie. It was really good. It was really good. And Passion of Christ. Yeah, guys, you guys can tell. I'm a Catholic, right? So, yeah, so Passion of Christ tells the story of the passion, death and burial of Jesus really well. It's not, people want to say it's the best biblical movie. I would put this on number 2. Except the biblical movie I'm about to put, you guys will see it soon. But yeah, Passion of Christ, I really love this movie. I really do. Like, I grew up in this movie, even though it's gory as heck. Like, it's literally, I'm pretty sure it's rated R. Is it rated R? Yeah, I think it's rated R. Because this movie is gory. So, yeah, this movie is really good, low-key. Revenge of the Sith, I would say, is the fourth best Star Wars movie. Mainly because of the fact that it led to the origins of Darth Vader and the end of Anakin Skywalker's Jedi, character arc and stuff. And, the final battle is, the two-thirds of this movie is literally the best part of the movie, and maybe even the best part of the Star Wars franchise. And this movie is amazing, it really is. People can get mad at me for putting Toy Story 2 above Revenge of the Sith. People don't like Toy Story 2. I like Toy Story 2 a lot more than Toy Story 3. I like the villain in that movie a lot more than Toy Story 3. It has good character arcs, good acting. We get to see the introduction of Bullseye and Wendy. I think that's her name. Yeah, Wendy. So, yeah, turn it. I don't know. I really like Toy Story 2. I grew up with Toy Story 2. I have the DVD for and everything. I saw it when I was a little kid. I grew up with Toy Story 2. It was probably the first Toy Story movie I really watched before I saw the first one. There, you guys will find out where that's going to be in basically the next video, because I spoiled it, but whatever, anyways. Madagascar 2, Return to Africa. I grew up with this movie. If you guys thought the first Madagascar was good, Madagascar 2, Return to Africa is just as good. Now listen. The plot of the dude that was trying to have a competition to be king of Madagascar with, who was apparently Alex's dad, it was okay. He's a good villain, but that plot line was just, I don't know. When then the fact that they made it to Africa again was really cool. I think they stayed in Africa, did they? I don't remember. I had to rewatch that movie, but yeah, Return to Africa is a really good movie. Guardians of the Galaxy, people want to assume this is a really good movie. The only thing I don't like about Guardians of the Galaxy, I could say, is mainly the villain, really. It's the villain and the character of Nebula. Those are the only two things I don't like. Like, the way they started out with Nebula was really slow, and then actually Van has a character in, Volume 2, Infinity War, Endgame, and all that. She would develop as a character, and that's a lot of character development she had. But in this movie, I didn't really like her because maybe because of her character arc was just, not, I wouldn't say boring, it was just super slow and like interesting. You know what I mean? But yeah, other than that, the movie's good. A lot of character arcs. Like, the chemistry is amazing, for sure. Good acting. Yeah, there's a lot of good things. And Mini-Type 2 is probably the same thing as well. Except the villain is the best part of the movie and the comedy. And then what else? Yeah. And then Monsters, Inc. I was going to put Monsters, Inc. a lot higher. But there are a lot of movies I forgot to put on this list that I had to put above Monsters, Inc. But Monsters, Inc. is a good movie. It's one of the best books on movies, for sure. And then Spider-Man 2. I personally thought that this was the second best Spider-Man movie, but I quickly changed my mind because the other two Spider-Man movies are a lot better, which I'm not gonna spoil who what they are, but yeah, Spider-Man 2, the villain's the best part of the movie. The ending is okay. I don't know how I thought about the ending. The ending was fine. It wasn't the best part of the movie, but I feel like the first hour of the movie is probably the best part of the movie for sure. And then, Spider-Man Homecoming. Spider-Man Homecoming, the villain in this is unbelievable. Vulture's not the best Spider-Man villain, but he's one of the best. For this to be Tom Holland's first Spider-Man movie, he did an amazing. He's one of the best Spider-Man actors for sure. He is the best Spider-Man. He is. And the plot of this movie is cool. It basically started literally right after Civil War. That's basically when it started, right? Like, maybe, like, a few days, maybe a few months, maybe, like, oh, all that, right? So, I don't know. That's why I love that movie. Now let's get on to, after 29 through 26, I'm going to start using the pictures of other movies. So, this video might be long as hell, but that's fine. So, let's just start with 29 through 26. Coming at 29, we have The Dark Knight Rises. 28, we have Pulp Fiction. 27, we have The Terminator. The first one, and then 26 have Spider-Man to the Spider-Verse. Now, Dark Knight Rises, there are people who don't like Dark Knight Rises. I don't know how you can think that. Dark Knight Rises is really good. It's one of the best DC movies, for sure. Bane is easily Bane and Batman, Christian Bale's Batman are easily the best parts of the movie. But I like Bane more than Batman in this movie, because Bane is an amazing villain. He's not the best DC villain, but he is one of the best. Like, the way they did Bane dirty in Batman and Robin was so unforgivable, and I never thought they would ever could pull off something like that until Dark Knight Rises came out. And I remember seeing this movie when I was 7 or 8 years old in the theater in summer 2012. I saw it with my dad and my brother, my youngest brother, and I was blown away. It was good, maybe even better than the Dark Knight. But I never thought that because Dark Knight is so much better than Dark Knight Rises, but you guys will find out what I'm gonna link that. But yeah, this movie is just good. I don't know how there are plot holes in the movie. Like, they never explained how time went by fast when Bane sent Bruce to the whatever prison Bane grew up in and stuff. They never explained the time frame of that time, during that time when Gotham was, like, basically, like, doing nothing without Batman. Like, basically, they were just acting like everything was normal until Bane came along and basically caused, basically, a 9/11. Basically, 9/11, but not as bad as 9/11. You know what I mean? Basically, it was a terrorist attack, basically. But I don't know. I like the Dark Knight Rises. And then Pulp Fiction. This is also another movie I recently watched. This movie is amazing. Quentin Tarantino was an amazing director. He knows how to make storytelling work perfectly. And this movie is a perfect example of it. Jules and Vincent are amazing, amazing characters in all of cinema. I don't care what anyone says. This movie is something good. It's not going to make my top 25, but it's something good for sure. And the way they made it chronologically, they made it like chronologically put the scenes in together after the movie. Like, we had said, oh, this scene came before, this scene came after. Like, the way he made us want to do that was so cool. And that's what I liked about this movie the most. And then Terminator. People are going to get mad at playing Terminator 2, the first Terminator over the Terminator 2, Judgment Day. I like the first Terminator a lot more because I grew up a Terminator. I've always been a Terminator fan. And, like, the first Terminator, I think it's easily the best one for sure. I think so. Terminator 2 was really good, but not as good as Terminator. But some people can disagree, but I personally think Terminator is better. And then 26 Men into Spider-Verse. It's Miles Morales, and then, you know, it's a multiverse, basically, Spider-Man. What more do you want? And Kingpin, I don't like Kingpin, but he's a good villain. Like, in this movie, he gets you so pissed off, like, oh my, why did he do that? How could you? Like, what is wrong with you? You're crazy. Like, he gave that, the Kingpin gave you that kind of feeling, right? In this movie. So, it's like, you know, yeah. But I posted the Homecoming, but it was so hard to put Homecoming and Spider-Verse in the same name. It was so hard to see which one is better, because they're both, I seen them both as the same ones. But, Spider-Man, Spider-Verse is a little bit better than Homecoming, I would say. It's a really hard decision. And guys, let's get to the top 25, 25 through 11, and I'm going to use the picture of the movie this time. 25, you have Son of God. Son of God is the best religious movie. I don't even know explain anything else. It's just the best religious movie, even though there was a lot of, most of it was just scenes from the Bible miniseries. But other than that, it's just a good movie. It's a good storytelling of the life of Jesus and his death and resurrection and the way and how he guides his disciples to do what to do after his death. Essentially, and all that. So, yeah, it's not really much I want to talk about this movie. It's just good. It's a great movie. It's the best religious movie. So, yeah. Yeah, 24, we have Madagascar. Madagascar is it's the second best DreamWorks movie. Because I've not seen How to Train Your Dragon. And people will say, oh, it's the best DreamWorks movies ever. I don't know, and I don't care about How to Train Your Dragon. I don't care. It seems like a good series, but I just don't care for it. I really don't care. Madagascar is one of the best DreamWorks movies other than the Shrek franchise and the first two Kung Fu Pandas. But even though the second Kung Fu Panda isn't on this list, it was at some point, but I had to remove it because, again, all the movies I forgot to put in this list. Yeah, Madagascar is a good origin story for four animals. Like, basically, four show-off animals in New York, where they're trying to live a New York-like lifestyle. Basically, like humans, like, you know, they want to be popular. They want to be like, basically what I'm saying is this: they want to be circus animals in New York and live the most human New York lifestyle they can. But that all is ruined until they end up landing in Madagascar, which makes the plot a lot more cool and everything. And I really, Ben Stiller is a good actor. But David Schwimmer, I loved him. I loved him ever since from Friends. And he was good in this movie, too. And Chris Rock is just unbelievable, too. The rest of the cast is amazing. Let's be honest. They are. Okay, and then let's start with 23, I Find Nemo. It's a classic. It's a good standalone Pixar standalone classic. One of the best Pixar movies. I don't even need to say much. We have Jurassic Park. Oh, my gosh. I love this movie. If you guys know how much, you guys don't know I'm a big Jurassic Park fan. I am a fan of dinosaurs. Not as much as I want to be a paleontologist, but I am a dinosaur fan. The way they made this work was just amazing. The way they made, and Steven Spielberg is a good director. He's not even good. He's just one of the best directors out there. Except the Russo brothers, Chris Nolan, and yeah, basically a good amount of directors, right? He's amazing. For sure. And then he made Jurassic Park what it is. And John Williams, the composer of the theme song, is brilliant. He made this movie so much better than it already was. And that's why I love about this movie so much. Like, the music gets you so intense to watch this movie. I almost cried when I saw the dinosaurs and the start of the movie. I'm not even joking. Like, I recently rewatched it. And I saw it as a kid. But I recently watched it, at the end of last year or something. It was just good, man. It was. It just is, honestly. But not as better as 21 movies I put over. At 21, we have Black Panther. So Black Panther is literally one of my favorite Marvel movies. Even though there are people who are overrating this movie as the best Marvel movie, like Guardians of the Galaxy and the movie that's also above this one, Black Panther is good. The villain is the best part. T'Challa is a solid character. He's one of my... Personally, I would prefer him over Hawkeye and Black Widow as an Avenger. He shouldn't have been one of the original Avengers. To me, Black Panther shouldn't have been one of the original Avengers. He shouldn't have been Avengers 2012. They should have not introduced him so before. That pisses me off. He shouldn't have been one of the first Avengers. And that's annoying. But yeah, this movie was great. The whole cast is just, like, the acting is phenomenal. The plot of this movie is cool. They started out a little bit slow in the beginning, but other than that, the movie was fantastic. 20, we have Captain America Winter Soldier. Now this, I can't think of a more overrated movie in the Marvel Cinematic Universe than this movie. But my lord, this movie hit me different though. This movie, I can see why people are overrating it though. Low key, it's not the best Marvel movie though. It's one of the best. I would put it as number seven. But Winter Soldier is like, it's basically a James Bond movie. Because Captain America wasn't really that liked in the first Avenger and the first Avengers movie. But when Winter Soldier came out, it changed his character arc to a whole other level. And the fact that Bucky Barnes came back was probably the best part of the movie. The fact that he was a Winter Soldier himself. The only thing I didn't like about this movie was two things. One, the fact that it's overrated, that's the main one too. Because it made sense when Nick Fury died, right? But that was confusing though. Like, how can you die in front of doctors but end up being alive a few days later? I don't know how that's possible. I think he said, oh, because I had this medicine or like shot or whatever that made him basically fake his death in front of the doctors and then come back alive in I don't know how many days or like maybe even hours. But yeah, that's what really confused me about this movie. But other than that, it was a good movie. People say it's better than Civil War. It's not better than Civil War. If I see someone say it's better than Civil War, I'm done. This is not better than Civil War. It's not. But still a good Captain America. It's one of the best Marvel movies out there. As good as number 19, we have Thor Ragnarok. Thor Ragnarok. The two first Thor movies are dumb. The first one I liked. I grew up with the first Thor. But the second one's garbage. It's literally poop. That's abomination. It shouldn't even exist. But Thor Ragnarok made the Thor character to make him, he made his personality and character a lot more better than it already was. From him being a demigod to being, you know, high, going through a lot of girls, knowing all that shit, right? I don't know how I even bring that up, but I just did this because I don't know why. But, like, Chris Hemsworth, the way he portrayed Thor in almost every movie he's been in the MCU is crazy. But it has to be one of his best movies in the MCU, other than Infinity War. Because in Endgame, but I didn't like the way he was fat. You know, I didn't like the fact he was fat, because, it made sense. Like, you know, he lost more than any other hero, any other Avenger, because he couldn't have went for the head, and he didn't go for the head. So that made him a lot depressed, and that made him, like, eat a lot, to the point where, what's that called? Stress eating, basically, that's what it is. Like, emotion eating, whatever it's called. That's basically what he was going through the last 5 years during that time. But Infinity War, Thor is the best one, and then Thor Ragnarok is the second best, for sure. Like, the villain in this movie is great. Hela is a good villain. I like the fact that they put Doctor Strange as a cameo in this movie. I like that a lot. Not even as a cameo. It was a cameo, basically, but it wasn't, like a 2 second cameo, like a Stan Lee one, like rest in peace Stan Lee, you know what I mean? Like, it wasn't like that. So yeah, guys, Thor Ragnarok is, what do you want me to say? It's the best one. It's number 6 for my favorite Marvel movie. And a lot more, so that's something you guys know. Coming at 18 is Shrek 2001. This is the best Shrek movie. I forgot the actor of Shrek. I literally forgot his name, but whatever his name is, he plays the character Shrek really well. And an ogre has all his daughters, but not want nothing to do with the world. He just wants to be himself, to chill, be as dirty as he possibly can, be as disgusting as he possibly can, and just chill for the rest of his life in his swamp, right? And then he ends up wanting to save a princess who ends up being in love with his life. But the whole part of this movie is cool. Lord Farquaad is one of the best villains in animation movies. One of the best, for sure. Like, I prefer him over Fairy Godmother. And whenever that stupid kid villain in Shrek 4 Forever After, like, and that's that dumb movie. Like, what's his name? The sword dude. I forgot whatever his name is. I forgot. That's all bad he's. I don't like him. I don't like him at all. Basically what I'm saying is Lord Farquaad is the best villain of the whole Shrek franchise. Is basically what I'm saying. Basically, for Shrek 4, they shouldn't just did the Shrek trilogy and that's it. There's on Shrek 1, Shrek 2, Shrek 3, and that's all they should have had. They should have never had Shrek 4, should have never came out, should have never existed, ever. I can see them making like a few shorts there and there, but they should have not made a Shrek 4. If they were going to make a Shrek 4, they should have at least made it good. At least as good as Shrek 2 or 3. That movie was poop. And this movie, Shrek 1, is the best one of the franchise. So that's what I love about this movie. I really love this movie, honestly. It's the best. Eddie Murphy as Donkey is the best part in the movie other than Shrek. But yeah, I love this movie a lot. I do, for sure. Anyway, guys, so I'm going to keep doing that. But coming at 17, The Incredibles. People want The Incredibles over the Toy Story franchise and all that, but I don't think that. This is one of the first superhero movies I ever saw, other than like Iron Man or the first. So this is one of my first ones I saw. And Samuel Jackson as Frozone is cool, is really cool. I liked him a lot in this movie. Basically, the whole Incredible family is probably the best part of the movie. The villain is awesome. The plot is solid. It's sort of a little. When actually, no, the beginning is probably the funniest part. When Bob was working at an office complex and like basically like a normal dad and like I don't know like he wasn't he like they showed off how he lives as a normal person like not without superpowers and then they show him superpowers. That's what I liked about this movie for sure. But the plot, the second third of the movie was the best part. The middle part of the movie I didn't really like about that much, but. Oh, yeah, the movie was cool. I liked it a lot. That's why it's at number 17. We have Logan. Again, this is one of the movies I also watched, like, recently. Not this year, probably like last year. Like, I didn't see it when it came out, but this is the best X-Men movie. I'm surprised no one thinks it's the best. And I haven't seen Days of Future Past. People have told me Days of Future Past is a really good movie. I haven't seen it. I've seen a few clips in there, but I haven't seen the actual full-on movie. I'm planning on doing that for sure. I'm planning on rewatching Days of Future Past, but not right now. But if that's the case, then I would still say Logan is better because one, there's only two way to other movies, the superhero movies. That's Logan. That's the Joker. Those are the only two I can really think of that are actually like rated R movies. And also, fun fact, Stanley never made a cameo in Logan, which surprised me. I'm surprised because he was still alive around that time. So I'm surprised he didn't really make a cameo in that movie. But yeah, that's what shocked me for sure. And then yeah, but Logan, the plot of the movie is cool. The villains really pissed me off. That's how good the villains are. It's the same thing of Kingpin and Spider-Man to Spider-Verse. It's like, they're so good that they make you actually feel the same way the characters I feel in the movie. Like, they make you feel some kind of way. Like, the villain in this movie, not X-24, but the other villain that was, like, trying to get them to kill Logan, kill Wolverine, the dude with the blonde hair, I hated him. Like, he was such a good villain that I just, like, what the fuck, like, what is wrong with you? Die, please, I don't want to see you, like, get out of my face. Like, this one of the movies that make you feel that kind of way. And a lot of movies that make you feel like that, for sure. So that's how good the villains are. Like, they just make you feel some kind of way. And that's why this Logan's the best X-Men movie. 15, Star Wars A New Hope. Star Wars A New Hope, it's one of the best Star Wars movies. People want to put A New Hope over Return of the Jedi. People, they're not putting over Empire Strikes Back. No way they're going to do that, obviously. But, like, to me, I put Return of the Jedi over A New Hope, for sure. But, like, New Hope, it's the best Star Wars movie. Like, it's a fun standalone Star Wars movie. Like, what more do you want from it? It shows the origin of Luke Skywalker really well, how Obi-Wan Kenobi has been living out his days, and basically it started one of my favorite villains of all time, Darth Vader. He was the best part of this movie. To me, Darth Vader is the best character of all time in Star Wars history. I don't care what anyone says. Darth Vader is the best. Hear me out. Look at me when I say this. Darth Vader is the best, not the best villain of all time, but the best Star Wars character of all time. Not just a villain, character of all time. And number two is Luke Skywalker. I'm really checking the camera when I say this because it's facts. Darth Vader is amazing. What more do you want? I'm not even gonna speak on this that much, on the topic that much, because that's only one word describing him. GOAT. That's literally all I can say about him. He's the GOAT, for sure. It wasn't because of the actor that played him. I heard he died from COVID, which is sad, but yeah, he was a good actor. I loved Darth Vader. I loved Star Wars: A New Hope. Yeah, guys, we're almost, we have like 4 movies left. Man, this movie is, this video is going to be long. So let's just continue moving. Let's just move on. 14, we have Furious 7. People are going to get mad at me for putting Furious 7 over Fast 5 and Hobbs and Shaw. But Fast Furious 7, I would say, is the best Fast and Furious movie. Now, one of the most anticipated movies of this year is, whatchamacallit, it's F9. That's the movie I want to see the most. And number 2 is Venom: Let There Be. Those are the 2 movies I want to see. Venom: Let There Be Carnage. Those are 2 movies I want to see this year. The main ones I want to see. And especially F9, because it really pissed me off when we were not locked on. They had to delay a full year. And it really bothered me because I was just that close to seeing the movie. But then it never happened. But I'm glad they're not delaying it, because they recently saw a 30-second trailer, like a snippet, in during the Super Bowl this year. So that made me happy, because I know that that's... Yeah, guys, so Fast and Furious 7... So Furious 7 is a good movie. So these are the best Fast and Furious movie. Now let's move on to the final 3 movies. You guys, coming at number 13, Joker. Now, I was hesitant to see Joker at first. Like, I saw it in theaters. I saw it a month after it came out, because my friends asked me if I wanted to come. I said, sure. I had a good time in the movie theater, and I was so blown away by how Joaquin Phoenix played the Joker. Like, he's one of the best Jokers, except Heath Ledger. But I'm gonna get to that soon. But yeah, this movie was a good. Even though we never saw him take on Batman, the way they made where they made him kind of related to the Wayne family was really cool. And like, basically the whole movie is just great. Honestly, it's a good origin story for one of the best villains of all time, for sure. Number 12, we have Cars. Now, Cars, people are going to get so pissed off at me for putting Cars over Incredibles, Monsters, Inc. and Up. People are going to get so mad at me for that. But I love Cars. I grew up with Cars more than any other Pixar movie, except for Toy Story. Cars, people don't like the Cars franchise. I personally don't care. I hate Cars 2. Cars 3 is fine. But Cars 1 is a good standalone Pixar movie, and I think that's the best part about this movie. That, like, a lot of people don't like it, but it's a good movie that you can just watch in the theater for however long it is, get a popcorn and everything, but you don't have to rewatch it as much as you like. But it's still a good movie that's actually rewatchable. That's what I love about Cars, because even though you may not like it, it's still a good movie to, it's still rewatchable, it's a good movie. But I love Cars, so, yeah, all you Cars haters, don't even come typing your keyboard in fucking cookie clips on in a bowl and shit. But yeah, just don't even. Movie of this list until my next video. Number 11, the first Iron Man 2008. Iron Man was one of my first Marvel movies I ever saw, or superhero movies I ever saw. Iron Man is literally my favorite superhero of all time. You guys can see, you guys might think it's Spider-Man. But it's actually not. It's Iron Man and Batman. It is, and then Spider-Man and Thor and then all that stuff. But then Iron Man, it changed superhero movies forever. Not just Marvel movies, superhero movies forever. And maybe even movies as well. Normal movies as well. But like, this movie is just... It's something that you wanted in the movie. I'm sorry about my brother. Just ignore that. But yeah, guys, this movie is amazing. It really is. I don't know how you can hate on Iron Man. I really don't understand the hate on the first Iron Man. But even though there's not a lot of hate on it, a lot of people like this movie, which I'm cool about. And the one thing I didn't really like about it was the fact that, what's his name? The villain, I liked him, but he wasn't like the best villain. So, I liked him in this movie. But other than that, the movie is phenomenal. And yeah, guys, that wraps up my top 50 through 11. Next video was going to be my top 10. Sorry you guys waited this long for this video. And then after my part 3 of my movie list series, I have an announcement at the end of the video, because I'm not going to make, I don't want to make a video like, you know, a video like that. You know, after this, even though I might, but I think I'm just going to, make a video. I'm just going to make the announcement at the end of the video. So yeah, guys, if this video, hope you guys enjoyed, subscribe, drop a like, comment down below. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. What's going on, guys? Editing Chris here. I just wanted to let you guys know that, if I sounded trained in this video, I apologize for that. While I was recording this video, I couldn't wait to make it, so I decided, once I was rushing it, I just wanted to, like, make it right away. And, like, during the video, I was keep getting distracted, my family was being loud, and then I was also watching my brother while I was making the video, and he was doing stuff that he shouldn't have been doing, so that's why I was acting really strange at the end of the video. So I apologize for being strange in this video. And also I said I was going to have an announcement, but I didn't want to wait till the next video, so I'm going to say it now. But I'm also going to make a big update video about this soon. I don't know when, but I will come out with news about this. But if you guys have seen, I made a playlist of all the apology videos I made. The new schedules, the new series I was gonna make, and all that. That was supposed to be a joke, but at the same time, I wanted to say something. I wanted to show like how I actually feel about you guys, because like that, what I did with that playlist was just to show you guys that I realized what my channel has become because of what I've done, apologies I made and stuff. And like, I did that because the fact that I couldn't stand to look at myself when I made all these promises, and I couldn't even fulfill those requests to make those videos, fulfill those promises and stuff. And that's why I did that, because it made me feel pissed, it made me upset, and also very angry with myself that I wasn't able to fulfill the requests or promises I made in those types of videos. And that's why I made that playlist, to show you guys I am going to move on. And here's how I'm going to move on. So the next few months, I'm going to give or take 2 or 3 months, like around, let's say, after Easter, if not before Memorial Day weekend, I will make this channel my second channel. Now you guys might sound confused, but here's the thing. I'm going to make a very updated video guys about this, and I'm sorry this video is already long enough. It's like around 40 minutes, but I just wanted to bring this up now. So if you don't want to watch this, you guys can just watch the next video I'm going to make, look after my top 10. But yeah, my plan for the future of my YouTube career is I'm still going to post on this channel, but I think it's not going to be my main priority, because the fact that my channel is, I would say it's basically dead. And I wouldn't say I'm not uploading constantly, because that's all it's been since 2018. I haven't been uploading as much as I used to, because back when I first started YouTube, I was killing it. I was doing the best I probably ever did in a while. And after that, I just completely fell off and stuff, and I just didn't feel the need to do YouTube videos that much, because I didn't have the love for this I did before, and I still have a love for it, but not as much as I did before. And that's why I made all the schedules and new series and stuff, because I wanted to, like, you know, like, do that as, like, you know, as, like, a sorry times kind of thing for not uploading. I wanted to, like, I don't know what's the word, like, yeah, I can't think of the word, but, like, I just wanted to, like, make guys happy for, like, since I was gone for so long and all that. So, just make a short and simple one, I'm making a gaming channel, because I talked to my friends on what I should do, because I don't want to, people are not going to watch the videos, people are not going to give me the attention I want, and if I'm going to keep taking breaks and stuff, what's the best thing I should do? And not one person told me that I should make a gaming channel, because that's what I mainly do anyways. If not a movie channel, but I'm probably going to focus on gaming, because that's what I mainly do, once I'm good at it, I'm average or something. I'm not going to say my skill level, but in video games, but you guys have probably seen one of my videos. So I'm going to make my second channel that I have now, my official main channel. I'm going to change the name. It's going to take me a while, but that doesn't mean I'm still not going to post it yet. I'm going to make that my main channel. My main focus on my content is officially gaming. Though that doesn't mean I'm going to quit posting on here. Again, this is going to be my second channel. I'm going to be making the videos I've been doing, except no gaming, because gaming would already be on. Maybe I'll give like BTS on like how tutorials and how I make my gaming videos and stuff, and when I used to edit my videos and stuff, and like I'll do reaction videos. I'll do like the movie videos I've been doing, because that's what I've been loved doing. Because I can tell, since I love doing YouTube, one of my careers I want to have when I grow up is being a movie director, a screen director. And I have a big passion for movies and storytelling and books and all that stuff. So, like, that's why I am making these types of videos. I have a passion for this type of stuff other than gaming. And, man, this video is already long enough. I'm talking for so long. But, yeah, I've sort of been making the videos I've been making. It's not as consistently But that doesn't mean I'm going to stop making YouTube videos for a long time, because I'm still going to, again, this is going to be my second channel, not my main channel, my second channel. And I'm going to make a new gaming channel. I'll try to do the best I can to upload there. And it's going to be mainly, it's going to be either PS4 games, iOS games, and some all that stuff. I'm going to have a lot of fun with that. Hopefully, I'm going to have my friends come on. It's going to be a really fun ride. If I had to give a guess on when that's going to be, it'll probably be either after Easter or like before Memorial Week. It's probably going to be somewhere around there, maybe even sooner than that in both those dates. But yeah, guys, I haven't talked for too long. I'm going to give a more in-depth, detailed video about this soon. I don't know when it's going to be. Maybe somewhere to one more time. I don't know. I can't give an official date. I know I'm going to get it wrong soon or later and not do it on the exact date. But yeah, guys, if this video... Sorry for talking too long. I'm finished editing this video. Yeah, guys, I'll see you in my top 10 video. Peace.